We want to complete a table using the function rule f of x equals the square root of x minus 2, and then use the information from the table to sketch a graph of the function. Remember, f of x is equal to y, so what we'll do is select values of x, perform substitution, and then determine the corresponding function value, or y value. And each time we do this, this will give us 1 point on the graph of the function. Now it is important that we take a look at the function before selecting values of x. Notice how whatever value we select for x, we're going to have to take the square root of it and then subtract 2. So the first thing we should recognize here is that x can't be negative because that would produce an imaginary number. So the smallest value of x that we can use would be 0. So let's start with 0. And then because we're going to take the square root of x, it's going to be easier if we select x values that are perfect squares. So for example, 1 is a perfect square because 1 is equal to 1 times 1. 4 is the next perfect square because 4 is equal to 2 times 2. Next would be 9. And then we could also use 16. Of course, we could select any value for x, but this will make determining the function value or y value a lot easier. So when x is equal to 0, to determine the corresponding function value or y value, we'll substitute 0 for x. So we'll have the square root of 0 minus 2. Well, the square root of 0 is 0. 0 minus 2 is negative 2. So this tells us the function contains the point with an x coordinate of 0 and a y coordinate of negative 2. When x is equal to 1, the function value will be the square root of 1 minus 2. Well, the square root of 1 is 1. 1 minus 2 is negative 1. So the graph of the function contains the point 1, negative 1. Next, we have x equals 4. So to determine the function value or y value, we'll substitute 4 for x, square root of 4 minus 2. Well, the square root of 4 is 2. 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. So the graph contains the point with coordinates 4, 0. Next, we have x equals 9. So we'd have the square root of 9 minus 2 for the function value, or y. Square root of 9 is 3. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So the graph of the function contains the point 9, 1. Looking at our scaling here, 16 is not going to be on our graph. So I'm going to go ahead and skip that and see if these 4 points are enough to make a nice sketch of the graph. 0, negative 2 is here on the y-axis. Next we have 1, negative 1, that would be here. Next we have the point 4, 0, the x-intercept here. And then we have the point 9, 1, which would be here. And this does look like it's enough information to make a sketch of the graph. It's going to start at x equals 0 and then pass through these points. So it's going to look something like this. Again, we know x cannot be less than 0 because we'd have a negative number underneath the square root. Another way to say this is the domain of the function, or the set of all possible x values, would be x greater than or equal to 0. Or using interval notation, we can express this as the interval from 0 to infinity, where it's closed on 0, meaning it includes the value of x equals 0. I hope this example was helpful.